Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to discuss the concept of variance analysis for direct labor. We'll start off with an introduction of direct labor costs and variance analysis. Next, we'll discuss how variance analysis is used to investigate the difference between the actual and planned costs in a business and see how companies can take corrective action if required. Understanding this concept can help companies manage their resources more effectively and make smarter long-term decisions. So let's dive in. Direct labor can be one of the largest expenses on a company's income statement. Companies spend a significant amount of money each period on salaries and wages paid to their employees directly involved in the production process. The ability to manage and control these costs affects the overall profitability of the business. In order to plan for future operations and control spending, most companies produce direct labor budgets, which they can use as a tool to evaluate how effective they were at managing both the rate and efficiency of their labor. At the end of each period, this allows them to compare their actual results to their budget and pinpoint the areas that didn't go as expected to plan. This is the key purpose to the direct labor variance analysis process, which helps companies identify specific differences or variances in the amount they spend on labor. This allows organizations to investigate areas of concern so that they can improve going forward. But what do we mean when we say direct labor? These are the costs that the company incurs on salaries and wages for their frontline employees. These are the employees who are physically in the factories or warehouses that are manufacturing the product. Every hour of their time can be directly linked to the units of production. The starting point for a direct labor variance analysis will be to calculate the total direct labor variance. This is done by comparing the actual cost of the direct labor to the budgeted amount that the company was planning to spend. The actual cost is calculated by taking the actual hourly wage rate, or AR, times the actual quantity of direct labor hours used, denoted by AH. The planned cost is calculated by taking the standard or budgeted hourly wage rate, or SR, times the budgeted quantity of hours, standard hours, which can be denoted as SH. The difference between the actual costs and planned costs will be the total direct labor variance. Depending on the circumstance, the variance could either be favorable or unfavorable. Favorable variances occur when the result has a positive impact on the organization's profitability. This would occur when the company's direct labor cost is less than they were planning to spend for that period. For example, let's say a company budgeted to spend $100,000 on direct labor, however, they actually only spent $85,000. This would leave them with a $15,000 variance between the actual and budgeted amount. In this case, since the company spent $15,000 less than they planned, this would be considered to be a $15,000 favorable variance. Unfavorable variances indicate an adverse situation when the actual cost is more than the budgeted cost. Let's go back to the same example where the company budgeted to spend $100,000 on direct labor. If something didn't go to plan and they ended up spending $120,000 that month, they would end up with a $20,000 unfavorable variance, since they spent $20,000 more than they planned. Anytime a variance is identified, it's important that the company determine whether this is favorable or unfavorable so that they can make a decision on how to proceed. Determining these variances between the budgeted values and the actual results is really only the first step. The next step, which can be even more important, is to spend time investigating the variances by breaking them down into components that will provide greater insight into the root cause. This can also involve additional discussion with department managers to understand what went wrong. In the example that we just discussed, where the company had a $20,000 unfavorable direct labor variance, they'll want to get an understanding on the root cause behind this. If management can determine why they spent more than planned, then they can try to rectify the issue so that it doesn't continue going forward. Did the variance arise as a result of the wage rates being higher than expected? Or was it as a result of higher volume of hours being worked than expected due to unexpected overtime or mismanagement of the workforce? These are important questions that will need answering in order to improve things going forward. More on this to come shortly. Now that we understand a little bit more about variance analysis for direct labor, let's talk about a common misconception. Just because a direct labor variance is unfavorable doesn't automatically mean that the company managed their costs or processes poorly. It's possible that there were elements outside of the company's control that led to the result. For example, there could have been unexpected economic factors that impacted the hourly wage rate, such as increases to minimum wage, or maybe the labor supply decreased, and in order to hire skilled employees, the company was required to offer a higher rate than anticipated. anticipated. Both scenarios would likely result in the company having to spend more money on their direct labor than they would have originally budgeted for, creating unfavorable variances. So while variance analysis is an important tool, it's important to remember that there are some limitations outside of the company's control. Let's go back to the direct labor variance analysis from earlier, where the company had a $20,000 unfavorable total labor variance. Like we discussed, this means they spent $20,000 more on their direct labor than they had originally planned. While this gives management some information, it doesn't tell the whole story. Now, in order for the company to understand what went wrong here, it's important for them to break this variance down further to determine the root cause. To do this, we would break down the $20,000 variance further into both labor rate and labor efficiency variance. To drill into these variances, we would need some additional details about hourly rate and quantity of hours. Here we can see the total variance was $100,000 minus $120,000, which equaled a negative $20,000 variance, which we said was unfavorable. The actual labor rate was $23.30 per hour. The actual hours were 5,150 hours. The budgeted rate was only $20 per hour, and the budgeted standard hours was 5,000 hours. Let's calculate the labor rate variance first. Labor rate variance is the difference between the actual amount paid to direct laborers and the amount that should have been paid based on the budget. In this case, that would be the $23.30 per hour minus the $20 standard rate times the actual number of hours, which was 5,150 hours. This result is an approximately 17,000 unfavorable variance, since the hourly wage rate ended up being higher than expected. Labor efficiency variance is the difference between the labor hours that were actually used compared to the total hours that should have been used based on the budget. In this case, that would be the 5,150 actual hours minus the 5,000 budgeted hours multiplied by the budgeted hourly rate of $20 per hour, resulting in a $3,000 unfavorable variance. As we can see here, the total $20,000 unfavorable direct labor variance has been broken down across both rate and efficiency variance, with 85% of the variance originating from the rate difference. Calculating these variances would help the company determine whether it was the hourly wage rate or the total number of hours deviating from plan that actually created the majority of the issue. In this case, it looks like there are some possible issues in both these areas, but the company would likely want to spend the majority of their time investigating the rate issue, since this is where the largest variance is originating. It's possible that the actual wages were out of the company's control due to economic factors. However, it's also possible that the company didn't efficiently manage their hiring and scheduling, resulting in the utilization of higher skilled workers when it may not have been necessary. It's also possible that the company failed to accurately budget for these costs in the first place. And that brings us to the end of this video. Variance analysis for direct labor is an extremely important tool that companies can use to manage and improve their profitability. It allows organizations to both pinpoint areas that are going well in the company, while also narrowing in on areas requiring improvement going forward. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.